Hi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will talk about how a conductor works. The copper atom has 29 positively charged protons and an equal number of electrons orbiting its nucleus in distinct shells. After filling the first shell with 2 electrons, the second with 8, the third shell with its maximum 18 electrons, the outermost shell of copper is occupied by a single electron. This single electron is loosely held in its valence orbit and thus can become a free electron. The ability of this electron to freely move away from its nucleus gives the copper atom its current carrying capacity. Let's take a more detailed look at how these free electrons flow when a voltage is applied across a copper wire. If we use the simplified version of a copper atom with its single valence electron, let's distribute this simplified version of copper atoms along the length of a copper wire. In the absence of a voltage, the free electrons in a copper wire will drift in random directions from the orbit of one atom to another. When a voltage is applied to the copper wire, the electrons can be directed through the wire, with the electrons moving towards the positive end of the source voltage. This movement or flow of electrons in one direction is called electron current flow, or just current. Materials that have free electrons and allow electrical current to flow easily are called conductors. Conductors, such as copper, have low resistance to electrical current flow and thus are used extensively in electrical circuits. I hope that you now know how a conductor works. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.